What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading to Windows 11 24H2 using Microsoft Intune. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about upgrading to Windows 11 24H2 using Intune. So let's get right into that, right? First thing that we need to do is log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. On the left-hand side, we are going to click on Show All. Boom. We're going to locate and click on Endpoint Manager. Just locate it. Click on it. Yep. Go for it. Do it. Now, do it. There you go. It's going to load up the Microsoft Intune Admin Center. Again, on the left-hand side, we're going to click on Devices. And within Devices, we're going to go underneath By Platform and click on Windows. Click on Windows. Now, within here, we're going to go underneath Manage Updates, and we're going to click on Windows Updates. Now, right in the middle of Windows Updates, you got a bunch of tabs, and the tab that we're going to get into would be the Feature Updates. We already created two profiles in the past. We did one for 21H2, and we did one for 23H2. It's basically the same thing. Nothing's changed. We're going to locate and click on Create Profile. Click on it. It's going to take you here. Provide a name, a description. By default, it is going to feature update to deploy would be version 24H2. So you don't have to do anything. I gave it a name. I changed it to make available to users as an optional update. It's not a required update. You are able to do that, but it's up to you. I made it optional. And check off when a device isn't eligible to run Windows 11, install the latest Windows 10 feature update. That's pretty cool. And then for the rollout option, make update available as soon as possible. You are able to change it to a specific day. It's up to you. Once you set everything here within your deployment settings, just at the bottom, click on next. And it's time for us to assign a group. So click on add group. You're going to get this nice side menu. Select your group. I'm going to select autopilot devices and then click on select. At the bottom, let's click on next. A nice little review, and then click on the button that says create. And on the upper right hand side, you should get a notification that Windows feature update deployment successfully was assigned. It was created. Awesome. And if you give it some time, there goes our new profile. Bam. That's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.